Well, we've done the rig that we're going to be using for the fishing. Now, getting down to the nitty-gritty of things, and I think probably one of the most important things in fishing is hooks and hook lengths. Now, just like the rigs, pre-tied, ready to buy, and it's the same with the hook lengths. Now, at Preston, I've been heavily involved in this. To get these right, it's taken a long, long time. And the GPMB pre-tied hooks, to be honest, they don't get better. They are tied absolutely perfect. I can, you know, to get them like that takes some doing, and they do it with ease, the people that do these. And it's really, really easy. This is the mag store system. I've got my mag box there. That's the actual box I use when I'm going fishing. Like that, it's a mag store box. You can see the hook lengths. All the information's on the little stickers. It doesn't get easier. And then all I do, you get these, take them out of the packet like that. This is all recyclable, so your cardboard can go in your cardboard and your plastic goes in your recycling for your plastic. Get asked that a lot, and it is all recyclable, so it's not a problem. Now, what I'm running out of these, some of the hook boxes, some of the hooks in my hook box. Tells you on there, 013, they're all tied on power line, and we all know how good that line is. And that is a 16 GPM. So that's absolutely perfect for F1s, if you're carp fishing. A 16 is bang on for, like, you know, pieces of worm, corn, meat. It's just an all-round good hook. And it's as easy as taking it over to your box, and they've got little magnets on, and they stick in like that. It doesn't get simpler. Obviously, same again, once they run out, stick your little plastic things in your recycling bin, and then it's job done. Now, if you want to use, like I do a lot, hard pellets, you need to use an eyed hook. And I'm going to run you through all the components and how you actually tie a band on for doing hard pellet fishing. Same hook. This is a GPM, but the eyed version. They're absolutely mega, mega sharp. All the hooks are PTFE coated, so they're not going to rust, and it also helps keep the point of the hook really sharp. Next thing is bands. Now, I've got two different pellets on there. I've got a 6mm and a 4mm. Now, if you're looking to fish with 4mm, then you really need to start using small latex bands like that. If you're not into sort of fishing with like 4mm pellets, and you want to be fishing with 6mm and 8mm all the time, then you'll probably want to use a medium band. Make sure you buy some good bands, you know, good quality, so they're going to last, they're not going to break. The last thing you want to do is changing your hook lengths all day with dodgy bands. Now, I'm going to use a medium band, which is easier to tie on, and it's easier to show you guys what I do. So I'm going to get one of the bands out of the packet. Like that. Get one of my hooks out, 16. I'm going to go opt for a 16. 16 is a great size for catching carp and F1s. Now, I used 018 on the rig that I showed you that I made. So I'm not going to use an 018 hook length. I'm going to drop it down to 016. That's going to suit what I'm going to be fishing for, and it's going to suit the rig. You know, really, really strong. Acropower 016, which is 5 pounds, 6 ounces, where the main line is nearly, is sort of 6 and 6.5 pound. Now, the first thing you've got to do is tie the band on. Now, the way I do that is get the band, put the line through the band like that, bring it round so that band sits in a little loop like that, then double the line over with your fingers, and I create a loop like that. So basically what you're trying to do is create, this band needs to sit in a figure of 8 knot. So if you try and learn how to do the figure of 8 knot, you can't go, it's the best knot, it doesn't come undone. So if you do like a normal knot on that, and you start messing about with the pellet, it'll come undone. But try and do the figure of 8 knot. And the way I do that is I actually twist my hands like that. So I've got it there, I twist it, and that's crossed the line over in that loop. And then this band goes through the bottom of that original loop. And then you can see that's now a figure of 8 knot, like that. Now what I do then is grab it, pull them two knots. It's a bit fiddly, but once you get into it, it's quite easy. Now don't let the knot go down to the band. tight. When it's in that position there, I actually grab both ends of the line. And then if you do it real quick, like that, the knot shoots down and goes right near the band. So it's all nice and tidy and nice and neat. Just yank that a little bit to get the knot nice and tight, which is perfect. But make sure you do try and do the figure of eight knot. It's really, really important. Knit that off nice and tidy, like that. Then obviously I'm doing a knotless knot. So what I need to do is cut that. Give yourself a little bit more line. We're doing six inch hook lengths, but give yourself probably sort of 18 inches of line to work with. That'll give you a little bit of, you know, help you tie the hook, especially when you're just starting out. Now I've got my 16 GPMI there. Now I need to go from the back of the hook to the front. So that's the point. The point of the hook is facing that way. So I go through the back first of all, like that. You just let that drop down to the band, like that. So it's actually coming off, if you can see that, it's actually coming from the front to the back, like that. Sorry, too far for me to show you that. But you can see the line coming through and into the band. Now, this is the most trickiest part that people get. But once you get into it, it all becomes. Now, what I try and do is get that band, so that band just sits a fraction below the bend of the hook. That's how I prefer it. Some people like longer hairs. I like it so it just sits below the sort of back end of that hook. So it's below the bend of the hook. So get that into position. It's a bit tricky with your hands. And then hold it. Now what I need to do now is I need to go down the shank, twisting the line around the shank of the hook. So try and get that as far as you can down, because that's going to help you go round. And then start off then, get that into position like that, and then start off going round the shank like that, but make sure you're going down like that. Now, loads of people do it different ways. I go down probably sort of 12, 13 times. Everybody's got their own little opinions on that. But I like to go down quite a way. So you keep going down. So it's 10, 11, 12, 13. Obviously, the further you go down, the more tricky it gets because you're getting near this, your fingers that are holding the hook. Now, what you've got to do is try and hold that into position like that. I just pinch that with my fingers. And then I need to go the opposite way. So I go from the back of the hook to the front of the hook. And that's what the GPMs are nice. The eye's nice and the right size, so you can get two lots of line through the eye. So you pull that through. So that's going from the back of the hook to the front of the hook. And before that tightens up, just give that a little bit of a lick. And then that's it. And that's perfectly tied like that. So you've got that. Just make sure everything's nice. Now, to get the length for your line, I've actually got one of these little mag sticks. I've actually cut the middle out, so I've got a little jig and I've screwed that on my workbench, so it makes it really, really easy. And I put my hook on one end like that, so I know that thing's 15 centimeters or 6 inches. Obviously, depending on what you're doing, you can just make little jigs up on little bits of wood, you know, or even just use the ones that are in your boxes. So I put my hook on one end, I come up to the other end, go round, make sure you've got your little loop, your loop sizer ready. So I've gone round the pin at the end, that's nice and tight, and then you need to fold it round and then grab it. So that basically now is the length that you want your hook lengths. Now you need to bring that off the pin, hold that like that. So this is where you need to tie your knot. So you've doubled the line over, you know now that that's the length that you want. And like I said, you can use a loop tire, obviously do it by hand. I go round, I only go through once, Lots of people do twice. I just do once. I've never had any problems with it. Like that, figure of eight knot again. That figure of eight knot, you know, if you're not great with knots, try and do the figure of eight because it's the best knot. Then my loop sizer, then I'm just going to use that 15 size again. Goes through the long one, through the middle. Like that. I mean, you don't have to use these loop sizers, but if you want everything nice and neat and looking pretty, then use one. And they do keep your, you know, they do keep your loops nice and sizable. So that goes on the end like that. Give that a yank off. So it's got your loop the nice size. Like I said, keep your loops a little that sort of size, because when you're doing your loop to loop from your main line to your hook length, a slightly bigger loop, it's just a lot easier, especially when you've got a band on. So nip that off like that. So that's my 6-inch hook length with my little medium band on. And like I said, with a 6mm pellet or an 8mm pellet, they're medium bands. I just stretch them over like that. And you can see that, I've just got that just hanging, just off the end, just off the bend of the hook. Absolutely perfect. And then I've actually got a little machine there, the GPM 01616. I use one of those little printout things there that you can buy. They're absolutely brilliant if you want to tie your own hooks and you want your little stickers. And just put the hook on there. Like that. Just push that hook down on there. And then you can go on tying your own hooks. You know, have a good practice and you soon get into it. It takes a little while, but once you get into it, and it's satisfying to do your own hooks. Absolutely brilliant system. And then, same again, got your mag box, stick that in there like that. And if you want to do your own hooks, you know, whether you want them pre-tied or you want to do your own hooks, it's nice and simple in there, stick it in the bag, job done.